Yes! What is up, everyone? And welcome to my AT&T interview masterclass with one of the best young players in all of MLS, Eric Williamson, who really came into his own during the MLS's back tournament, and that helped his Portland Timbers win not only an awesome trophy and a ton of bonus money, but also a spot in the CONCACAF Champions League, which is a very big deal. So let's hear what he had to say during his time in the bubble.
What is up, everyone? It's your favorite former MLS player, Jimmy Conrad. And in collaboration with AT&T, we are bringing sports back. And we're starting with Major League Soccer, who are currently hosting a big tournament in Orlando. So I can't tell you how excited I am to talk to one of the best young players in the league, Eric Williamson from the Portland Timbers. What's up, Eric?
What's up, Jimmy? How are you?
I'm doing great. I mean, look at this. Face and hair. It's all working for me all of the time. Now, before we get into what you're currently doing, and congratulations to the Timbers for getting into the knockout rounds, the quarterfinals, let's start from the beginning. What was your first reaction when you heard that the season was going to be suspended?
You know, I think everyone was in a little bit of shock. We kind of heard the NBA and their cases, and we were like, oh, you know, maybe this is, you know, a little more real. And then it shut down, and I think about 2 or 3 days, and everyone was kind of like, well, what is there to do now? And I think the team here did a really good job of getting us equipment so that, you know, right away we were staying fit and continuing our fitness, not knowing, you know, when we'd be back playing again.
Yeah, so tell me what that's like from the mental perspective, because as a former athlete myself, I was very goal-oriented, right? I needed something to work towards. But because of the uncertainty and not knowing, I feel like that maybe would have stifled my motivation in some ways. Even though I feel like I'm a hard worker, I'd still feel like, why am I exactly doing this? Did you run into that as well? And how much did that kind of seep into maybe the whole team?
No, for sure. I think, you know, we were right out of preseason. So a lot of us are kind of like, okay, maybe 2 or 3 days off and, you know, we get back to work, but we had no timeline. So I think that's where, you know, people started hitting a little bit of a road bump is, okay, when is the right time to start pushing a little harder? And I think our staff did a great job of knowing when just to push it a couple weeks and take it a little easier, but like also being able to build fitness and also maintain it. So I think there was a healthy medium. And I think as a player, the motivation was, you know, we had to be ready whenever, you know, they said to be ready.
Looks like based on how you guys are playing, you figured it out. So congratulations on that so far. Now talk to me what it's like to be in the bubble playing in these games where you don't have any fans.
Yeah, I mean, it's just a lot of, it's bringing our own energy. On the field, it's, you know, a lot of it feels like preseason games to an extent. And, you know, the way everything kind of came about, it has a preseason feel to it, but knowing, you know, what the games meant, you know, going out there for regular season points, you know, it's a little bit different, you know, approach to the game. But I think, you know, off the field, it gives us, you know, the club feeling again. You know, a lot of guys came down here for Disney Showcase growing up, or, you know, Surf Cups, or, you know, different tournaments across the country. And I think, you know, it gives us, you know, that childhood feeling again, like, ah, you know, I feel like I'm in a club tournament. So, you know, there's good and bad to it. But I mean, at the end of the day, you know, we're all playing soccer again. So I know we're all happy to do that.
When you go on the road, there has to be some juice that you get from somebody heckling you like, hey, Eric, are you going to just stand on that left foot or actually use it? You know, I mean, you got to miss that a little bit.
No, for sure. And I think, you know, on the road, it's, you know, scoring a goal and silencing a crowd. It's like it gives us a little more, you know, step in our game, you know. And I think it's you heard it with Seba scoring in Kansas City. I believe it was last year, the year before. It's just, you know, he's just yelling at the fans and the fans have nothing to say. So it, you know, and being in front of the Timbers Army, it's, you know, our 12th man. So we definitely miss them, but we also, you know, miss playing on the road. And we have always have long stretches on the road. So this to an extent feels like, you know, the opening of last season. So
during this time, how are you staying in touch with your loved ones?
I FaceTime my mom a good amount whenever, you know, day after the game, 2 days after the game, just to catch up. You know, she just calls and just checks in on and off the field. And, you know, a lot of it's just like, hey, what are you doing off the field, to kind of stay busy. And my brother's at home, so he's always trying to like, oh, Eric, you want to get on the game? And I'm just like, no, not right now, like later. And they're just always, you know, trying to get me to stay in touch, you know, just try and figure out what I'm doing at all times. So
now tell me about how you prepare for these games in particular, because as we know, the situation is a lot different. You know, sometimes you have a game at 9 in the morning, sometimes you're playing at 10:30 at night. You know, what are you doing to make sure that you're let's say in peak form when the whistle blows?
It's a lot of quick turnaround. So it's, you know, we take what we do well in games and we make sure we make that a focus point of the next game and continue to do those things, and then obviously shift it towards our opponent. So I think it's, you know, different approach to games, and it's, you know, they are coming really, really quickly. So we always have to, you know, make sure we're tuned in, you know, checked in right away. Like as soon as we step on the field, it's, you know, making sure we're locked in for these games.
All right. Thank you for your time, Eric Williamson.
Thank you.
I'm such a good interviewer. Way to go, Conradinho. So thank you for watching and for your support as always. And if you want an autograph from Eric Williamson before he becomes a big star on the U.S. men's national team, I might be able to help you out. I know a guy. All right, I'll see you soon. Later.